check this out.
What the fuck are you guys doing?
Where I realized Zoë Bell would be terrific in the film was she starred in a documentary called Double Dare. It's about her life and the life of Jeannie Epper, who was kind of the first legend of stunt women, and Zoë being like the new blood and Jeannie being the old guard, kind of telling their story simultaneously. And so they were making the movie about her. I didn't know this at the time when she came to audition for Kill Bill, and I ended up giving the movie a whole third act.
Hi, I'm Quentin.
I'm Zoë.
Hi, nice to meet you, Zoë.
How you doing?
But you watch the movie with audiences, and when she actually gets Kill Bill and you see it on screen, you can't help but start crying because she has that kind of personality in real life.
I'm gonna double entertainment.
You captured on film, it just comes out in the audience. You care about her, you love her, you're just charmed to pieces by her.
God!
So I knew she had that quality.
I've always talked to her as an actress because I don't know how to talk to anybody that's performing other than an actor. So I always talked to her as an actress, and she started acting like an actress.
He asked me things like, what's your motivation? What are you trying to get out of this? As opposed to me just being like, I need to get up to the top of that banister, or I need to take out those six dudes before I move on. He really encouraged, I guess, acting in me, which I found a little bit hard to get my head around to begin with. Right up until I realized he was deadly serious, and then I was like, okay, well, that's part of my job to do what this man asked me to do, so engage acting.
So I wrote this part for Zoë so she could play herself, and that way, one, I could have this wonderful stunt woman who could do the entire thing, so that would add this really exciting, scary level to the cinema that would be different than what audiences are used to seeing, especially in an American movie.
Well, he told me that he was going to write this movie, and he told me that I would be in it. But the way I heard it was that it would be like a featured extra. Might walk up to the bar and be like, can I have a pint, mate? Cheers, and that would be it. And he'd be able to go, that's my stunt woman, you know.
But you guys see what I'm talking about?
Yeah. And when we get here, we sort of like...
One point he rang me and said something like, I've finished writing my script. I was like, oh, cool. He was like, I want you to read it. And I was like, okay, don't know why, okay, I'm happy to read it. And then he started saying things like, well, maybe I'll come over to see you for dinner. And I was like, why are you coming all the way to see me to have dinner just to have me read? I don't understand.
And then on his way over, he called me and said, oh, by the way, Robert's done something to the script cover for you. So when I saw it, my name.
I, of course, think that's a joke just for me. And I'm like, oh, that's hilarious. That's funny. Mum and Dad are going to love it. My friends at home are going to think that's hilarious. And then he opens the page and there's my name and an introduction. I'm like, oh, fuck, wow. And then he's kind of flicking through the pages. I keep seeing my name again and again. And I'm sitting there just sort of, are you... Why are you not explaining how that this is a big deal? Am I, you know, missing something?
No worries, mate. I've got it all worked out.
And it was hilarious because it all sounded like me. Like, he'd written me. I mean, not just by name, but my lingo and everything and some of the stories that we'd actually been through together in China. And so that was, it was pretty shocking. That's when he kind of hit me with it. And it took me, I mean, we went out and drank beers after that. So I was a good shock dealer. But, I certainly wasn't prepared for it to be that way.
It's so cute because she's still shocked by the fact that she's acting and the fact that people, you know, call her as one of the actors, and she has her own chair and she has a photo double and you know, a stand-in and all that kind of stuff. But it's amazing how natural she is, and she's never really done this before, and she jumped into it and she was great.
And action.
The girls I'm acting with in this part are brilliant. I mean, they're like a godsend to me. I mean, I was prepared for people feeling kind of pissed off or frustrated by the fact that some stunt woman's in here. There's been none of that. I mean, in fact, if anything, they've been so supportive and excited for me.
It was very cute because she would talk about, like, the action stuff is like real work. And when she would talk about, like, the talky stuff, it was like something that really blew her mind. She was like, oh, this is the talky stuff tomorrow, you know, and like really freak out.
Be like, can you guys do my lines with me? And I'll supply the wine. I mean, hours we'd spend.
Having a couple glasses of wine, I was gonna say bottles, which is probably more accurate, but I'll say glasses. And we'd have a couple of glasses of wine and we'd just go through the lines all the time.
I mean, when I first sat down to even read lines, reading them out loud, even just with Tracy, me and her outside in the garden, I would blush and get all twitchy and feel weird, you know, and she was like, ah, don't worry about it, blah, blah.
And she is so great. From the very beginning, she was so natural and so great.
I mean, I know I don't usually be blessed very often, but I feel truly blessed by the team that I have around me, the stunt guys, the girls, Quentin. I mean, I'm starting off somewhere pretty fortunate, you know.
People might think, well, she's playing herself, so, you know, it's not that hard, but trust me, it's, you know, if you've never acted before in your life, most people would be pretty atrocious at it. You know, it takes a while to catch on, and she was amazing from the get-go.
Action!
It's weird. I mean, the concept of that was a little bit more confusing to me before I started. So I would talk to people, and half the people were like, oh, it's easy, you're just being yourself, you don't have to act. And the other half the people, most of whom were actors, are like, that can be quite difficult, acting yourself and not just kind of get lost in the screen, you know?
Whew. That was a close one.
Zoë Bell, she's comfortable doing the things that she's doing physically. I think she sounds right, I think she looks right, and I think that she's very good in this movie.
Okay!
She's like the Steve McQueen of female actresses. You know, the girls that like to do their own stuff, and Steve used to do all his own stuff, you know.
Now that's what I'm talking about!
You know, at one point we even talked about not getting her a stunt double, but like her hand has got to grab a belt. Well, then that could be somebody else's hand. She's like, no. No, no, we're not doing that. If I get cast in a movie and I'm doubling for Sharon Stone or I'm doubling for Uma Thurman, that will always be my hand. You know, you just need an insert of somebody grabbing the sword. That will always be my hand, all right? If, you know, if I'm hanging off of the hood of the car, it would be my foot on the bumper for Uma Thurman. No, I'm going to be that hand. I'm going to be that foot. I'm going to do everything I would do if you cast me for another movie, except I'm also going to play the part as well. That was her insistence on that.
I'm really glad I got to do my own stunts. I mean, for a number of reasons.
All right, guys, rehearsing again for camera.
It would have been really hard for me to watch someone else do it, firstly. That's my ego talking. The other thing is, you know, people always say you're pissed off that the actors get all the glamour and attention. And, you know, to be honest with you, that never bothered me. I didn't become a stuntwoman to be some movie star or anything. But I would find infuriating is you'd get a mean gag or an amazing stunt that we'd worked out and we'd shot in different angles and it looks fantastic. But the one angle that sells it and makes it look incredible, you can't shoot it that way because you see my face and the actress can't do it. So you lose the best shot. You lose it because you can't shoot it that way, you know? What's been so freeing about this process is watching something on screen, and I recognize it's me, obviously, but then you turn to my face, and my instinct is, oh, no, I blew it. But then it's like, oh, no, that makes the shot, like, $1 million now because you can tie it all together that way, you know? Obviously, I love what I do already, so it's not imperative that I turn out to be some movie star or anything, but I actually enjoy being challenged. I mean, I'm completely outside of my comfort zone with camera in my face, you know? Like, camera behind me, no problem. Camera in my face, very unusual.
And you've just gone through the gate, and then you see the barricade.
Kim? Fuck.
That was good. Your little serious face is really cute.
Quentin. He's one of the longest friends I've had in this country. I mean, I didn't know anyone in America before I worked on Kill Bill, and he's really one of the people I've known the longest, and I consider him a good friend. He's changed my life now twice.
But then when you get him...
I was on my way to Canada for a couple of months, and then I end up in China, doubling Uma on the Kill Bill movies. You know, and cut to 4 years later, he's... putting my name in lights, you know. And yet, at the same time, when I'm on set with him, it doesn't feel any different to me. And for him to be the guy that's done this for me, you know, I remember the day I first met him. And, I've loved every day since. Fuck you, aren't gonna make me cry.
Thank you for not getting killed.
Me too.
My pleasure.
It would have been a real buzzkill.
Cheers! I'm done talking, dude. You haven't written me anything.